Alan Turing matriculated at King's in 1931. He received a first in part two of the mathematical tripos in 1934 and was made a fellow in 1935 for his work on the Gaussian error function. Turing's preface acknowledged that, like many a doctoral candidate before and since, he was partially scooped by another researcher. Apparently, the electors to fellowships were not too bothered by that. Turing's fellowship was proposed by no less a figure than John Maynard Keynes. Keynes wrote to his wife Lydia in March 1935, "I had to lunch today the fellowship candidate, who seems much the cleverest on paper, to inspect him. He is excellent. There cannot be a shadow of a doubt about it." Turing stepped in for a possibly hungover number five in the second May boat for the 1935 bumps shortly after his election. In the spring of 1935, he stayed in Cambridge and attended Max Neumann's Part III lectures on the foundations of mathematics. These concluded with an outline of David Hilbert's call for an answer to the question known as the Entscheidungsproblem: was mathematics decidable? Neumann encouraged Turing to consider whether there was some mechanical process which might be applied to a mathematical statement to ascertain whether or not it was provable within a defined context. Throughout 1935 and into 1936, from his rooms at the top of Bodley's, Turing worked on his proof, guided by Neumann, and wrote it up for publication. He phrased the problem in terms of computable numbers. He wrote to his mother on the progress of this paper, noting the appearance of a similar treatise by Alonzo Church. Determined to specify a definitive method, he described a machine, the Turing machine as it became known, working with a paper tape bearing printed symbols. What was the most general type of process this machine could perform? This article presented a breakthrough in abstract mathematics and provided the core concept for the later development of computing, the practical physical embodiment of an electronic machine supplied with logical instructions to perform any number of operations, a multi-purpose electronic computer that came to be known as the universal machine. Part of this foundational article is reproduced on the £50 note launched on Alan's birthday in 2021.